big talk right now where sport is concerned is, of course, the Winter Olympics that are due to begin in Sochi sometime soon. But, like, it's been crazy, man.
It has been a bit mad. And this, you know, we've heard Sochi. I went onto the official website to get the launch, you know, where they actually awarded it. And it's Sochi, believe it or not.
Sochi.
Rolls off the tongue nicely. But it does. It kicks off today with a couple of events. And then we have the official opening ceremony tomorrow. There has been so much build-up going to the Winter Olympics. It's actually quite weird to believe that it's here now. Now all the controversy starts to kick in, who's there, who's in, who's out. But the opening ceremony, you know Russia are gonna go bigger and better. We saw the British Olympics were spectacular. And I don't know what you thought, a very different kind of, oh, look at that.
That's beautiful.
Doesn't get you pumped. Ewan started his education yesterday.
I did, with curling. I had no idea what curling was.
What?
Yeah, I really had no
idea. One of the greatest, most boring sports ever.
Roll ball
ever. Yeah. But dude, yo, let's talk about controversy. I mean, the story of one of our Winter Olympians who, but maybe you can straighten it out. I understand that this is Steve Spielman, who qualified to participate in the Winter Olympics, but is now not allowed to go for some reason. Yeah. What's the story?
Yeah, we went to the official word, and as it comes out of our Olympic, or SASCOC, the South African Sports Confederation, obviously, having made the qualification criteria, he had earned his spot. And you would think for a South African to do that in the context of a Winter Olympic sport, I mean, what, we've got the Drakensberg. You've got like one fake ski slope to be practicing on. But these guys obviously have to spend a huge amount of money. Yeah. There's a lot of traveling involved. They have to train overseas. And it's a stiff competition out there. So he has made the qualification criteria. However, there are certain clauses in the Olympic legalities that do allow the local body to make a decision. Now, he would have been able to get a spot if it was judged by our own organizing committee that they wanted to send him. We saw in the Summer Olympics that they made decisions based on the likelihood of an athlete getting a medal. And they also take into consideration the recommendation by our High Performance Center. So all of these minds got together and decided that he wasn't going to be a likely medal hope, obviously, and that's the brush that we're painting it with. But he isn't within that top 500 in the world, so it would have been, in their defense, like sending him over for a Russian holiday.
It's heartbreaking, but
there are massive budgetary constraints. These guys have to send athletes over that are likely to achieve success. Otherwise, funding could be spent on someone else who is likely to score a medal. That being said, on the flip side of that coin, how are we ever going to improve or have athletes that are going to knock on that door if we don't devote those
funds? Like you said, the amount of training, the amount of money that just went into his training alone, I think he deserves that spot. If he qualified, he needs to be there.
That's the thing. That's my only thing. And I mean, you know, as a sportsman, you train your whole life. You do your best in every single competition to try and compete among the best in the world. And if you've been given that chance, I understand the legalities of the local organizing committee. But come on, man. It's like saying, and I hate to be the devil's advocate, but it's like saying, don't ever send Bafana Bafana to any World Cup again until we're sure we can at least beat Zimbabwe 5 times in a row. Because you know we're not going to win right now. We're struggling, but at least we still stand up for them and we support them as our fellow country. Come on, the guy.
100%. No, it is, and especially when you've got Zimbabwe sending skiers over, where you've got possibly a cool runnings two coming out of the fact that Jamaica are sending a bobsled.
But I mean, but like we know, there's lots of excitement. I mean, we're all excited to see the Jamaican bobsled team. I mean, you know, of course, I mean, it's one of my all-time favorite movies. But
is that from the movie or from an actual competition?
What does that rhyme again? Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride. Amazing, absolutely amazing. So maybe there's a second movie coming out, but there's a lot to look forward to. So basically today's the turn of the figure skating, freestyle skiing and snowboarding. That's the first event that'll be up. And like we said, the opening ceremony taking place tomorrow as well, which will, I mean, they will have to do a lot, like you said, to top London. What they did in 2012. And then on Saturday, this whole host of events, I think one of my favorite events, ski jumping, where they can literally jump over 100 meters. And this is as close to flying a human being.
We're talking over 100 meters that these
That's
guys.
That's far, man.
What must go through the mind when you are launching over 100 meters? And then, of course, the strange yet eloquent sport of curling.
Which I am very familiar with now.
Do you agree that it is an Olympic sport, like Olympic-esque?
I was watching a video on it, and it's a very quiet, you know, subtle. The only if there's any you know, violence on the field, it's literally between, you know, talkies like, that was not fair, you did not slide, whatever, you know. But it's one of the fastest growing sports in the US, I heard, as well.
Yeah,
it's
amazing. They could have something to do with the weather there at the moment.
You should try it. It's stress relieving.
Really?
Maybe we'll set up a little curling board here.
That'd
outside,
be great,
you know.
Thank you.
I liken it to air hockey for grown-ups. Yeah. But the Winter Olympics kicking off in earnest today, and then of course we are going to see the opening ceremony tomorrow, so you better watch and you better give us your take on what should be a very Russian, very wintry kickstart to what is going to be a very exciting game. So we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with the Bishop's Choir and more.